Hello friends, welcome to the video on 120 days strategy for CAT. Here we will be discussing what should be your study plan and what should be your test taking plan for scoring good marks in CAT. And by good score I mean 99 percentile in CAT. Okay. So first you need to know how much you need to score in CAT. Okay. So if you want to score 99 percentile overall if you want to score, then you need to score 95 percentile in each of the sections. Why am I saying so? Because there are many faculties who will be appearing for the exam. They will be scoring good in their particular section. But then you are obviously not competing with them. If you score 95 percentile in each of the section, your overall score will be in the range of 99 percentile. Okay. So last year 99 percentile was at a score of 140 marks. If you do the total, this is 135 marks. Okay. If you score 55 in VARC, 30 questions in DI, 30 marks in DILR and 50 in QA, the total is 135. So if you score 95 percentile approximately in each of the section, your overall score will be in the range of 99 percentile. Okay. Now, if you have to score 55 marks in VARC, that is nothing but 18-19 questions correct out of 34 questions. Okay. In DILR, it is just 10 questions correct out of 32 questions. And in quant, you need to score 16 to 17 questions correct out of 34 questions. So normalization is not in our hand, but getting the question correct is in our hand. So let us forget about normalization and just focus on the number of questions which we get right. So when I said 10 questions correct, so if you get 11 correct and 3 wrong, that is equivalent to 10 correct. Okay. Why? Because we have plus 3 minus 1 marking scheme. So understand this. The game is to leave a question than to solve a question. In DILR, you need to solve only 1/3 of the paper. In quant, you need to solve only half of the paper, and in verbal you need to solve just few questions more than 50% of the paper. So how well you leave the question is important. How well you solve the question is obviously important, but how well you leave the question. If you try a question for 2 minutes and then leave it, or you just read the question for 30 seconds and then leave it, that will help you decide your score. Okay. So focus on 95 percentile in each of the section. Overall, your score will be 99 percentile. Okay. Now, let us look at the study plan. What I would recommend, daily solve 2 RCs with a timer of 30 minutes. Okay. 2 RCs with a timer of 30 minutes. Okay. Why 2 RCs? Because out of 34 questions in verbal, 24 questions are on RC. So you cannot be poor with RC. And if you focus on RC daily, and let's say in 120 days, you even if you execute this plan for 100 days, you will be solving around 200 RCs. After solving 200 RCs, I guarantee you that you will be very good with your RC section. Okay. And once you have focused on RC, I mean almost all of your verbal section is taken care. Then on alternate days, 2 sets of DI with a 30 minute timer and 2 sets of LR with 30 minute timer. Okay. So on Monday you will take 2 sets of DI, on Tuesday you will take 2 sets of LR. Okay. Every day after you are done with it, you will have to analyze it for 30 minutes. Okay. So how much you are investing? So you are investing 1 hour for RC and 1 hour for DI or 1 hour for LR every day. So that is 2 hours. Let us make a practical schedule. Let us not make a schedule for 8 hours or 10 hours because we know that it is impossible to follow that kind of schedule. So let us make a schedule of, let's say, 4 hours to 5 hours, and which is something which is very much feasible to execute. Okay. Now, based on your capacity, now that you have utilized 2 hours of your time in a day, now what we expect you to solve, we expect 2 hours more from you. So once you give 2 hours, so on what topic you will give 2 hours? 2 hours will be on quant, or 2 hours will be on grammar, or 2 hours will be on critical reasoning, okay, or 2 hours will be on something like statement assumption, statement conclusion. Okay, so what you have done by investing 1 hour in RC, you are taking care of verbal section. Okay, by investing alternate days on DI and LR, you are taking care of DI LR section. Now you have to focus a lot on quant, and you need to focus on all these other topics as well, because CAT is not the only exam which we are preparing for. Other exams are heavily dependent on these topics as well, like NMAT will have 10 questions, 12 to 12 questions on RC, but around 15 questions on grammar. So we need to focus on grammar as well. Okay, so these topics are for other exams, and we need to focus on other exams as well. We need to have our backups ready. Now, what in quant? I mean, if you consider quant, you must be thinking that quant will have so many topics and so many things to cover. Okay, what I am saying, decide which topic you want to do on a particular day. Take around 30 questions, or let's say one of the exercise from your book. One of the exercise from your book of, let's say, 30 questions on quant. Have a timer of 60 minutes. Okay. After these 60 minutes, I mean, what I'm expecting, around 18 to 20 questions must be done in this 60 minutes. Okay. So it depends on your level. You are very brilliant with the quant, then take difficult questions. If you are not that brilliant, you want some more practice, take easy questions. Take questions from R.S. Agrawal or R.D. Sharma and all. Okay. So take 30 questions and have a timer of 60 minutes. Every topic. Let's say now that you have taken allegations and mixtures. Allegations and mixtures you have taken. So you have taken 30 questions and 60 minutes timer you have applied. In these 60 minutes, what I'm expecting, you should cover 18 to 20 questions. Okay. After these 18 to 20 questions, now in remaining 60 minutes, look at the solution for remaining 12 to 10 questions which you have left. Okay, this is it. This is it. 30 questions on a particular topic are sufficient. Allegations and mixtures is, at the most, is it is going to give you one question. So I don't want to invest 2 days to 3 days in one topic. Okay, so let's say something like profit and loss, finish it in 2 hours. How will you finish in 2 hours? Solve 30 questions. 30 questions will be more than sufficient to get a hang of topic of profit and topics like profit and loss, allegations and mixtures, time and work, etc. Okay, from these 30 questions, what you will get, you will have the basic idea of that topic, and that is sufficient for us. So out of 34 questions in quant section, what I am saying, only 10 questions will be difficult and 5 questions will be easy. But still we are left with 19-20 questions which are of medium level. You can tackle those 19-20 questions which are of medium level by solving 30 questions of each of the topics. Okay. Also, what I am saying, if you try to complete the cover the complete topic in one day, it is not possible. And then if you invest 2 days, 3 days on a particular topic, you will be wasting your time, because allegations and mixtures and topic like these, they are going to give you one question. So is it worth investing 2 days, 3 days in it? No. Okay, so have a plan like this. What I am saying, this plan includes your verbal section, DILR section, which you are focusing on daily basis, and then on quant. So out of 7 days of a week, I would request you to focus on quant for at least 4 to 5 days. Okay, and then on every Sunday, or maybe on a weekly basis, what I expect, that you take a mock and analyze the mock. Okay, so what should be your mock taking strategy? At this moment, when CAT is around 4 to 5 months ahead, what I am expecting in verbal section, you need to score 12 to 13 questions correct out of 34 questions. In DILR section, I am expecting only 6 questions correct out of 32 questions. And in quant section, I am expecting 10 questions correct out of 34 questions. Go with a strategy like this. Don't go with a strategy of solving the whole paper. That is not the case. As I have told you, you need to score 140 marks approximately plus minus 5 depending on the difficulty level out of 300 marks. So half the paper you need to leave. This is what we need to achieve after 5 months. Right now what I am expecting this month, you need to focus to get these many questions correct. And on monthly basis will increase the number of questions which you will get correct. Okay. Focus on this. Go with a strategy. Go with a calm hand. Even in con section, let's say if you start and first 5 questions you don't get, don't panic. You out of remaining 30 questions, you need only 10 questions correct. So don't panic. How well you leave the question is important. Remember this. Okay. So we like this, we are going to come up with many more informative videos. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and like our page on Facebook. Thank you so much.